All right, so I have this other curve here. Which is three-dimensional. And we're going to make a three-dimensional ampersand. So to do that, we're going to go to Attribute Editor. Just reset all this stuff. Connection. We're going to turn on Curve Render. We're going to set the mode to Thick. We're going to turn on Level Area Light, Rig, Rebade 1,000 times. Turn on Simple Set. It's just two planes. And then we're going to render. Let's see what we get. All right, so let's see here. First order of business, make a shader for this thing. I already have a curve shader, but let's get rid of it. Say create material, standard surface, curve, surface, and then it's white for now. Go over here. Our shape. Plug our new shader into there. All right. Puffy. Kind of cool. Needs a little more work, but it's fine for now. So let's see. There's other parameters we can mess with. So let's see. The first one. So we can't plug textures into this, because basically what this curve shader is, it almost like clones a bunch of spheres along the path. You can kind of see that a little bit at the end. It's just a bunch of spheres. But we can change the shape, the scale and color of those spheres. So to do that, in the base, I'm going to plug a ramp. Clearing my selection, AI ramp, awesome. And we want a V ramp. No idea why it's a V and not a U, but that's what it is. And then we can, you know, plug other colors into this thing. And yeah, have like rainbow colors. Kind of fun. Let's see. Let's make rainbow colored. Make it candy. Shiny. Shiny. Candy ampersand here. Maybe we'll do orthographic front. Clean. All right. Now, we can also plug a ramp into the width. So I've tried the Arnold ramp into the width, and it doesn't work. I don't really know why, but it doesn't. So we're going to go over here to the node editor. I'm going to grab my curve, clear everything out, and add my curve. Alrighty. Then I'm going to create a ramp. So we're in the node editor now. So the node editor lets you see more nodes than you can see in the hypershade. The hypershade is just shader nodes, but the node editor lets you see more stuff. All right, so I made a ramp. I'm using a Maya ramp and not an Arnold ramp. I'm going to take the out color red, and then other, and then I'm going to plug that into the AI curve width. This is the only way to do this, because for whatever reason, if we look over here, there's no connection input, but you can still make that connection. And we can see, like, pretty awesome. Smooth. Right, I mean, you can already see, like, how cool this could be. You know, you could play with thicks and thins and fun shapes. You could also, if you wanted, animate this through the curve. So to do that, I'm going to set the default color to black. I'm going to set the wrap off. And then if I animate, if I scrub the V parameter, I'm like moving this color through the wrap. It needs some sound effects for that, right? Pretty fantastic. So there's a lot of possibilities here. You could also, if you wanted, plug noise into here. Gets crazy looking thing. So once again, we're going to go out color R to AR curve width. And we can. Yeah, so here's you see that it's actually just a bunch of spheres kind of cloned along a path. You can kind of see the wizard behind the curtain, so to speak. See? But, you know, once again, pretty cool. All right.